always in public?
No.
No. But it feels like it takes many times to try it in public.
Exactly.
Yes. So keep trying. Is everybody familiar with this piece? It's a very, very famous piece. Mm-hmm. And Mr. Rachmaninoff was instantly famous with this piece. So you really know the story, that's great. And he came, you know, everybody demanded it as play it. So I think he had to play it all the time. And towards the end of his life, he was not very pleased when he was asked to play this it piece. There's a funny story. I used to know Mrs. Maxine Marx, who was the daughter of Chico Marx. Are you familiar with the Marx brothers? Chico Marx was one of the early, like from the 20s, I think, the comedians. And Chico's Marx, Harpo Marx, was a very good harpist. And if you watch their films, they're always playing some kind of instruments or singing and dancing. It's great. And Harpo Marx was supposedly playing this piece in a hotel lobby somewhere in LA. And then the hotel attendant came over to Harpo and told him to stop playing the piece. And he was really offended. Do you know this story? Yeah, he was really offended because he was playing this great Rachmaninoff.
Harpo, not Chico, but Harpo.
Harpo was playing on the harp.
On the harp.
Yeah. And he said, how could you do this? How could you ask me to stop? This is a great, great piece by Mr. Rachmaninoff, Sergei Rachmaninoff. And the hotel attendant said, but excuse me, sir, the request is coming from Mr. Rachmaninoff. Apparently he was staying in the same hotel.
Oh my God.
So I always love that story, and it came from the Marx brothers. So, couple of suggestions. I really like how you're layering your sound in the beginning. You have a lot of bass and the high notes, the chords, you're tucking it in. The image that I get from you is that you're tucking those sound inside those low notes. I really like that.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's great. The very beginning felt a little bit unsettled to me. And maybe because you have to speak and you have to sit down and start playing, maybe you don't have to rush those first three notes.
Uh-huh.
You know, let it be, what's the tempo mark?
Yes, lento.
Yeah. So not too agitated, you know?
Uh-huh.
And there are half notes, yes?
Four notes.
Yeah. Four. And then it's whole notes, yes? Yes, can we start that again?
Yes.
Because I think you change a little bit too late and then this is gone. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so where would be a good place to start? It's called the circuit. Yeah? Is this good?
Cool.
Maybe not, maybe you start.
Thank you.
riding a roller coaster, if you liken this passage to a roller coaster, this is the top of the roller coaster mm-hmm. before it comes down. Mm-hmm. So it needs to sound a little bit more exciting like that.
Uh-huh.
I like it better myself. Do you like it?
Yeah.
You might want to practice this a little bit. Do you practice without pedal sometimes?
I do.
Mm-hmm. Good. And because you want to accentuate the left hand too. I hear a lot of the right hand accents. There's an accent on every beat. It's a triplet figure that she's playing alternatingly between the left and right. And so some of the accent falls on the right and some of the accent falls on the left. And I hear a lot of the right hand accent, but I would like to hear a little bit more of the left too.
Oh, mm-hmm.
Let's see if you can do that very slowly. Yeah, to hear that accent. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So, this one too. Yeah, yes.
Continuing more.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Did you think so too?
The phrasing seemed clear.
You don't think so?
I saw someone say. Yeah.
Okay, we need to wrap up a little bit. But I want to talk about the very, very last one. Last chord.
Last chord.
Yeah. Yeah. It's pianissimo, right?
Yeah.
How long do you expect that chord to sound? How do you want it? Yes, for a while, very long while, it's a whole opus fermata. And how do you want the pedal to be released?
It's a last note.
Yes, very slow release, yes?
Slow release.
Let's try to realize that.
Thank you.
I like how you're very sensitive in playing that, especially in A sections. It's very beautiful, and I can tell you really like it a lot.
Yeah.
It's well, well played. I think the main thing I'd like to talk to you about is when things get a little bit louder and exciting, I'm not really quite sure what you want us to hear most. There's a lot of sound, and it's not an easy piece for the audience to understand this piece. It's harmonically quite advanced. And I think you can think more about how to make it simple for the audience to understand what you want us to hear. And then the other thing I wanted to talk about is, and I see it in the notes here from your professor towards the end, it says Rachmaninoff piano is mezzo forte. And I kind of agree with that. I feel that, you know, his symphonies are not written for chamber orchestra, right? He didn't write for chamber orchestra. His symphonies are for a lot of people. It's for big, big orchestras. And I feel like your sound is a little bit like it's small. Think of the piano or mezzo forte to have a little bit more people playing, like there's a little bit more body to the sound. Maybe the character is, it's not the actual decibel of the sound. I feel like your decibel is a little too low. But you can still try to create a calm sound. Like a big ocean can be calm, right? It doesn't have to be a little pond to be calm, right? But think a little bit more large scale sound. So those are the main two things maybe I can do a little bit with you. So let's start right at the where it starts to develop a little bit, right? Yeah. So let's start from here.
Thank you.
right bell, more, you know, there's a resolution, you know? But remember, it's ocean resolution, not a little pond. Okay? Let's try that one more time, and then let's go on, okay?
Thank you. though it's all in one hand, it's not necessarily just one thing, mm-hmm. right? Sometimes you have to break it up like that.
Yeah.
Now let's see if you can play that a little bit more with your ears too, because now you know how it works. Yeah?
Thank you.
was just one try. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And make your sound a little bit more Oshan. Do you have any questions? Good. All right, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
want to portray?
I feel like it's a character that's sort of intense, but like trying to let it out of his anger.
Angry? Yeah.
Maybe he's, and then
there's a lot of anguish. Yes, I think, but do you hear some kind of grandness to this piece as well? There's something very grandly romantic about this piece. I mean, there's just no question, it's so over the top romantic. No? And I feel like sometimes you underplay that aspect. You make it a little bit less grand, or less romantic, you know, less. Oh, I think you can be a little bit more indulgent at times, and I don't know how often, how recently you have rehearsed with your Miss Tibbetts. Have you worked recently together? Okay, because it sounded a little bit like you know how it goes, you know how her part works, and you know when you're supposed to come in. But it was like a, if it was like a theater conversation, you didn't let her really, you didn't really hear what she said. You assumed that she said it. And then you didn't have enough time to react, you just played. In other words, I feel like sometimes you can wait, actually a lot of times, you can wait before you come in with your statement. You don't have to hurry up. So there's a little bit more of a sense of spaciousness to your playing in general. So maybe we can work a little bit on those two things. Actually, we may not even have time to work on the second aspect. You know, I'm sure Ms. Tibbetts is very much aware of that. You can figure that out. But let's start with the very beginning. It says, andante sostenuto. Right? Sustained. And the dynamic marking is forte. And he says ad libitum. So he starts with a big cadenza, right? And what is that low G? How long is that low G supposed to sound? Held the whole time. Do you notice that this kind of disappears rather quickly? You know, Saint-Saëns was a great organist, right? Can't you imagine that organ pedal working like that? That's what you have to do. You have to hold it. And if you have to take some notes with the left hand, maybe that was the reason, right? You have to somehow not cut it off with your pedal. Yeah, yeah. Is that your idea?
To use the middle pedal?
You forgot.
Okay, let's try it again.
At least until that cadence. recitative. You know, it's like a monologue you're starting. You're starting an epic story.
Here is the song. Here is the aria. And what is this, what does Saint-Saëns tell you about this aria? What, how does he characterize it?
He says it right here.
Espressivo. Espressivo, right? I think you're thinking piano, because the last dynamic you saw is piano. I guess it's not loud. Here is the loud. Second verse is louder, but I think it's a little too pale. I admit that this time was a bit better than the first. What I miss is music. Okay. Where is the depth of it? Where is it going? This melody. Where in music, yes. Where is that phrase going? If you were the singer, it's not I don't think so. Yes, that's second time, but actually it's, I believe, it's going.
Thank you.
that is marked appassionato with accents, it's very dramatic, for those of you who don't have the score. That's where you feel it changes? Because you play it like that. You play it like that. I actually think it's not there yet.
Did you try that?
And then that will be the last thing.
Thank you.
So could you start from here?
Thank you.
hear that low notes with the right hand going higher. Uh-huh. Like, it's a little bit funny again. Okay. Yeah, you can do that.
Thank you.
talk about that a little bit?
Sure.
Just this moment.
Yeah, here.
I feel like this, can you play it for them? Thank you.